Now he's going back to the mountain that first inspired him to climb, to tell a story that has haunted him since he was a boy. It is the tale of a great adventure that, just like his, turned into a terrifying test of endurance.
When I was 14, I read the story that stayed with me for the rest of my life. It was the story of Tony Kurz. It says so many things about friendship, courage, and strength of the human spirit. It inspired me to climb. But in many ways, it's my story. We thought it was worth risking everything. And we did. It would have been so easy. So I can imagine what it felt like hanging in that room.
It must have been heartbreaking for those guards to leave him there.
And it's hard
because he knew that he wasn't going to make the night.
I need some distraction.
Never have asked for rescue in his life. And he was pleading almost childlike for not to leave him.
In the arms of the angels.
Tony Kurz set out to climb the north face of the Eiger on the 20th of July 1936. He and his fellow climbers were only the second team in its history to attempt it. Kurz was 23. Newly qualified mountain guide from Bavaria. He was climbing with his friend and fellow guide, a brilliant young rock climber called Andreas Hinterstoisser. They had joined up on the climb with two Austrians. 27-year-old Willy Angerer was the eldest. His partner, Eddie Rainier, was the most experienced, a highly talented route finder and mountaineer.
Oh.
Their progress up the north face that day had turned into a public event. They were being watched from the valley below by a cluster of reporters and tourists.
As you approach the bottom part of the face, you climb a series of shattered rock walls and rubble-strewn ledges. Then you get under the rope flume. It's a tiny feature on this face, and yet it's 1,000 feet high, an overhanging wall of rock. Then round the corner to the edge of the first ice field. The second ice field is this great swathe of ice, 1,800 feet wide. It's steep, it's getting steeper, and every time from now on that you get onto rock, it's getting steeper and steeper, until you get right to the base of the great ice sheet called the White Spider. If you fell at this point, you would zip out into space, you probably wouldn't touch anything for 5,000 feet.
It was the scale of this vertical rock face that defeated the first climbers to attempt it.
I knew people died on mountains, long before I had my axe.
Below Kurz, Willy Angerer was almost certainly dead. Killed on impact with the rock face. And out of sight above him, Eddie Rainier was dying too. The weight of the two climbers on the rope around his waist would have crushed his diaphragm and slowly asphyxiated him. It would have taken him 10 minutes to die.
Inches down towards safety, feel it below, the knot tight against his fist. Then he knows instantly what the problem is. And the guides there, helplessly screaming encouragement to him, "You can do it, come on, just one more effort." They could hear him mumbling unintelligently to himself, trying to exhort himself with one last effort to force this knot through. And it wouldn't go. Suddenly, he sat forward. He stopped fighting the knot. And he said in a clear, strong voice,
"Ich komme nicht mehr."
unfinished.
The rescuers who watched Kurtz die were never able to reach his body. He was finally cut free by a team of mountain guides from Germany, who arrived just too late to help in the rescue. 3 days after his death, the Swiss authorities banned all climbers from the North Face. But 4 months later, after a legal challenge, the ban was lifted. For ambitious young climbers, another public tragedy had only added to the legend of the Eiger. Tony Kurz and his fellow climbers, Eddie Rainier and Willy Angerer, had watched as Andreas Hinterstoisser unlocked the heart of the North Face. In honour of his brilliant climb, it was called the Hinterstoisser Traverse. And using that route, a team of German climbers made the first descent 2 years later in 1938. In all, 8 climbers died trying before the last great north face of the Alps was conquered.